Hello, my name is Butch and this is Seasports. We're going to be conducting your resort course training today. This is some of the marine life that we'll be seeing when we're under the water diving. Scuba is a safe, non-competitive sport. There are no risks involved in what we're going to be doing off the beach in chest-deep water. We have to teach you some of these safety procedures in order to make you a safe and competent diver. And we're going to do this after you watch the video and then go down to the beach in front of your condo or hotel there. There's no cost for the training that we're going to be conducting in the shallow water. That enables you to take the time to get comfortable with your equipment and the safety procedures so that when we do get ready for our first open water dive, we can ensure that is a safe and a comfortable experience for you. This will be Jeffrey, he's one of our students, and Brianna will be our other student today. And we're going to be training them. There are actually three things we have to train in order to become a safe scuba diver. We have to train the escape mechanism out of you. Everybody wants to, if they get anxious under the water, try to escape. Breath holding is a very important consideration when scuba diving, and also, surprisingly, the instinct to swim, to propel yourself through the water on the surface. Those are three things we have to train out of you. We're kind of putting the equipment onto the tank here and getting things set up so that we can get in the water here. We're training in a pool here today and so that we're enabled to film it, but we're going to be training you off the beach in front of your hotel or condo when the time comes. So we want to introduce you to the saltwater environment as soon as we can. It's a little bit different, a little bit more buoyant, and has some other considerations for our mass clearing and other things. We're going to get the equipment ready here in a second and suit up with our lead belts. And make sure that when you put your lead belt on, the buckle is in your left hand so that it's swing it around and kind of lean forward. That'll make it a right-hand release. You want to make sure the lead is kind of split in the back, has room for your tank so that it's very comfortable. If it isn't comfortable, we'll have to adjust those leads. We're looking pretty good now. We're going to see if you're wearing contacts or left-handed. Those are two considerations we have to keep in mind. And I think we're ready to get in the water here, and I'll hand you your tanks. And you can put them on in the water. I'll open them up here. You put them on just like a jacket, and then you do your waist strap and your cummerbund. They only weigh 2 pounds once they're in the water. They weigh 40 pounds when they're out of the water. So we want to usually use our gear in the water. It's much easier to handle it and put it on in the water. These are the regulators and the jackets that we're going to be using with your scuba tanks. I'll slip them on here. Again, just put it on like a jacket. There we go. And then reach around your waist strap. Do that up nice and snug. Get Jeffrey here. We'll put yours on. And snug that up. Make sure all the hoses and everything are clear. And we want the pressure gauges retained and things so that they're not hitting our coral. We have to make sure that nothing is dragging along the bottom so that anything that touches coral kills coral. So we have to be very careful of what is hanging down from our bodies. We're defogging our face mask here. We're spinning it, rub it around. We know that God wanted us to scuba dive because he gave us spit for defogging our face masks. We're going to rinse it out. And then we'll place them on our head. When you put your mask on, make sure it's high on the back of your head, sitting low on your upper lip. It should be comfortable and off your ears. Okay, we're going to look for the gear here. You're going to look for your safe second. That's kind of that bright green one there. It's hanging on your right-hand side down around your waist. It's contained there, and that's where it lives. But we'll be using that when we come to our sharing air portion. That's it, right on the side. Also, you have your primary. That's doing a sweep, your arm sweep, to take that around and up over your arms. That's your primary regulator. If it's not over your shoulder, it'll be hanging down on your right-hand side. And if it's not there, you'll do your arm sweep. This is our gauges, our pressure gauge, our depth gauge. And the pressure gauge is very important. It keeps track of how much air you have left in the tank. So when you get down to 1,000 PSI, you want to give me a hand sign telling me you're at 1,000. You want to give me a 5 fingers and a 10 fingers to tell me you're at 1,000 PSI so that we know and can get you back at the anchor line safely for your ascent. The other is your depth gauge, which just tells you your maximum depth that you've gone. Okay, we're going to practice our regulator clearing now. You want to take a deep breath. When you take a deep breath, you want to take it out of your mouth, tip it down, make that ah sound or hum, put it back in your mouth, and then blow. Very good. Let's try it again. Deep breath, take it out, tip it down, give the ah sound back in, and give it a puff out. Try it on your own up here. That's it. And back in, and blow. There's another way to clear it using the button in the front. Press that button right now while it's in your mouth, and that'll give an air supply to you. All right, deep breath, out, take it down, and put it back in, and press your button again. Try that on your own up here. Very good. Making the ah sound. Outstanding. Okay. Now what we're going to do is go down, and I'm going to ask you for the first way to clear your regulator, give it a try. After you do it the first way, okay, I'll ask for the second way, give it a try. After you do it both ways, I'll ask you to practice, then I'll go to Brianna. First way, second way, okay, and then you will practice. Remember, the first way is take a breath, take it out, hum, put it in and blow. The second way is to take a breath, take it out, hum, put it in and press the button. Let's do it. We're down practicing. First way, second way. Independent practice. Very good. Jeffrey is going to be taking a deep breath, making the ah sound, all the way until he puts it in and blow. Very good. And now he'll do it with the button, making the ah sound, and back in and press the front button, which clears the water out of the regulator as well. Okay, he's going to be practicing. We'll have Brianna give it a try. Okay. Take it out, hum, put it in, blow. And let's try it with the button. You take it out, give the ah sound, keep humming, and press the button. Very good. Very good. Looks like we've got this skill down perfect. Let's ascend. Remember, you always must make the ah sound so that you're never holding your breath while you're under the water. That's very important. Your lungs act as a balloon. You don't want your lungs to be overexpanding while you're diving. It's an easy solution to this problem, as always breathe. We're going to take our face masks off now and put them on our arms. We're going to put our regulator, our primary, into our mouth. And I want you to go down and inhale and exhale 4 times. You may close your eyes, but I don't want you to hold your nose. After you've inhaled and exhaled 4 times, I want you to stand up. Here we go. The seas, if anybody, will be breathing through the nose. You have to pretend like you're sucking the air through a straw. You draw it in and you blow it out, like you're sucking in and blowing out through a straw. Very good. Everybody was successful at that exercise. We're going to practice our face mask clearing now. We're going to flood the face mask, then press on the upper rim, and then tilt her head back and gently exhale out through your nose while we're looking up. You want to empty your entire lungs out through your nose to clear your face mask, but you want to do it gently. Let's try it up here. Flood. Let's press on the top ring. Tilt her head back and gentle exhale. There we go. All right. Remember, the gentler you blow, the more successful you'll be. If you blow hard, the air escapes, the water remains. You've got to exhale your entire lungs out through your nose gently. Without the regulator, we're going to go down and we're going to flood, press, gentle exhale through our nose. When you see that you're successful, open your eyes, you'll see that you've done it correctly, and then I want you to stand up. Remember, it's flood, press on the rim, and gentle exhale through your nose. Let's try it without the regulator. Deep breath, and we're going down in flood. Press, exhale gently through your nose. All the water will get gone. They're trapping the air. We're not blowing the water out. We're trapping the air. We're successful. We opened our eyes, we're standing up. Okay? Very good. This time we're going to do it again. Let's do a full face mask. We didn't get it all. Let's do it completely. Pull it all the way off this time and fully flood the face mask. Let's give it a try. All the way off, fully flooded. Head back, gently blowing out. All the water is displaced, leaving only the air in front of your eyes. Salt water will not sting your eyes. It's only the air that stings your eyes after the salt water has been removed. That means you will not have two problems occurring at the same time. Very good. Excellent. Off the beach, and we'll practice that some more, but with the regulator in, you have to move your tongue to the back of the throat in order to clear your face mask. Okay, let's practice our inflation and deflation device. Your left hand, I want you to have that inflation device. The button on the side will inflate it, and the button on the end will deflate it. What we want to do is inflate the jacket, put just in increments. Don't just press and hold the button. That'll just shoot you up. You want to put enough air in the jacket just so that you start to float up. Once you float to the surface, you want to empty the air out of the jacket by pressing the end button, and you'll sink down. Second time, you'll do the same thing. Inflate up, deflate down. Third time, I want you to inflate, but this time, on the way up, I want you to stop halfway between. Let a little of the air out so that you're neutrally buoyant. That's halfway between. That's neutral buoyancy, and I want to see if you can attain that. All right, regulator's in for me. Let's lay on the bottom, on our stomachs, and practice our buoyancy exercise. We want to keep our legs straight behind us, our knees locked, and our body stiff. Remember, put the air in the jacket in increments. When you float up, you're going to reach the surface, then empty the jacket, and you'll be back down. Okay, let's see how we're doing with this. Here we go. Empty the jacket, we'll lay on our stomach, keep your legs straight behind you, keep your body stiff, air in the jacket in increments. Until our head reaches the surface, you raise it above your head, press the end button, letting the air out, and you'll be back on your stomach. Try it a second time. Air in, and we're floating up. Deflate the jacket, and we'll be back down. Now this time, let's see if we can stop ourselves halfway between to hover. This is neutral buoyancy, takes a little air in. You gotta wait for it to adjust. Takes a little bit of skill. Your breathing is going to get you going up and down, but if you get your breathing just right, you're not on the surface and you're not on the bottom. You're neutrally buoyant. That's a very important principle for scuba diving. You want to be neutrally buoyant when you're diving. Side button puts air in, and the end button, that's a side button for air in, and the end button on the end of the unit will take the air out. By pressing that end button and holding it up, the air comes out of the jacket. Air in causes buoyancy or floating. Air out is negative buoyancy, and it'll cause you to sink. All right, the out of air sign is a hand or a finger across the throat. When I give you that out of air sign, I want you to take your safe second, pull it out of the keeper, put it in front of my face mask. I'll take it. I'll put it in my mouth and breathe on it. Notice that the hose is on my right-hand side. I don't want it on the left-hand side. It has to be on the right-hand side in order for you to breathe through the regulator properly. What do I have to do before I can breathe on that? Right. We have to clear it by pressing the purge button or blowing out. Otherwise, we're going to inhale some water. Okay. So, when I come down, we'll give you the out-of-air sign. You put it in front of my face mask. I'll take it and I'll breathe on it, and then I'll ask you to stand up. I'm going to share your air with each of you, and then I want you to be sharing your air with each other. Okay? Sharing air exercise. Remember to put it in front of my face mask, not in my mouth. All right, let's put our regulators in, head on down, and do our sharing air exercise. The out of air sign, a hand or a finger across the throat, meaning I want to share your air. You pull it out of the keeper, put it in front of my face mask. The hose is on my right-hand side. I clear it. I'm breathing. And we're going to stand up. Perfect. She's giving the out of air sign. Jeffrey's giving the regulator to Brianna. She purges with the button, breathing on it normally, and she will stand up. Okay. Let's go down and let's have Jeffrey give it a try. All right, Jeffrey, give the out of air sign. Oh, we're going with Brianna again. We're okay. We're coming up. This time Jeffrey is going to give it a try, and he's making a mistake. We're going to have to correct this mistake. Out of air sign, but there's no bubbles. He's not blowing bubbles. You must make the ah sound whenever the regulator is out of your mouth. We'll have to correct this so that in the practice, Jeffrey is making sure that he's making the ah sound. All right. We've covered the safety procedures that we're going to need to be a safe diver. Now I want you to practice two ways to clear the regulator. Take it out, hum, put it in, blow, take it out, hum, put it in button. I want you to practice face mask flooding and clearing. And I want you to practice that neutral buoyancy, the hovering halfway between the surface and the bottom. When you're comfortable with all of those things, then we'll take our gear off and come out and warm up. This means my ears are not clearing if you're on the anchor line. I'm a little nervous. We're going to wait if that happens. You know the out of air sign. Okay, we've finished now. We're going to hand up our lead belts. Hand them up with your right hand so the buckle faces down. After your lead belts are taken off first, then you want to release your left shoulder strap by squeezing the edge of the buckle. It'll pop it open. That's it. Release that one. And then do your waist strap and your cummerbund down in front, and then you want to swing the tank off of your right hand shoulder. I'll just grab them here and we'll pull them up and we can hop out and warm up. That covers the practice session of the dive. After your practice, we're ready for our first open water dive. If you're comfortable and I think we're safe, then we're ready to get on the dive boat and our first open water dive. Now, this is going to be a commitment for you to do your first open water dive. So if we need more practice, we're going to have to do it in the shallow water, because once we get on the dive boat now, we are going to incur the costs of the dive. On the dive boat now, getting ready for our first open water dive, putting on a wetsuit to keep us a little bit warmer. The water temperature is probably about 80, 82 degrees, but the wetsuit just helps keep us a little bit warmer down there. Putting the regulators on the tank, checking to make sure we have air. We're going to turn our tank on, make sure that we have anywhere between 28 and 3,000 psi of air. Lead belt on, make sure it's a right-hand release. Buckle in your left hand and the leads are spread. We put our tanks on while we're sitting down on the boat, because the boat has some wave action, so we don't want to fall over with our tanks. Stick your arms through it like a jacket, slide right back into it, and then pull your cummerbund around and kind of use a Velcro to hook that up. Okay, got that set. Okay, we're going to put some air in the jacket, hold your mask front and back, and then we just lay back in the water. And you float right back up to the surface because you have air in the jacket. And then we're going to swim forward to the ball in the front. You come in, you hold your mask, and you swim forward to the rope, the descent line in front of the boat. Once we get everybody in here, we're going to start our descent, and you have to be very careful when you're going down to make sure that you equalize your ears. It's very important that you gently squeeze your nose and blow back gently into your middle ear so that you don't experience any pain. You're not supposed to feel your ears. If you're doing it properly, you're able to go down squeezing and blowing frequently and not feeling any pain. Blow gently. If you have to blow hard, you have to go up a little bit. You're waiting too long on the anchor line to equalize your ears. You want to come down nice and slow. Also, if you're holding your nose all the time, the pressure in front of your eyes might build up, so you have to kind of put a little puff of air out through your nose to equalize the pressure in front of your eyes. You could have some sinuses, which are in the middle of your forehead or in the top of your head. If they start to ache a little bit on top of your eyes, those are your sinus cavities that are not equalizing, and we have to work on those as well. Yeah, everybody looks very neutrally buoyant here. They're straight out and nicely trimmed, so they're not touching the bottom or touching any of the coral. Your flippers produce most of the power, so your hands, or swimming with your hands, is something that we don't need to do. But we need to keep our depth controlled with our buoyancy compensators so that we remain level and on an even plane and not touching or kicking any of the coral. The idea is to breathe normally, very comfortably, as you're cruising along, looking at the soft corals here on a little bit of mini wall. The visibility is very good today. You can see the boat in the background. And the idea is just to relax and to maneuver very cautiously around the corals. You're not touching or kicking anything. And this is where your buoyancy compensator comes into play. Remember, if you change your depth, you have to equalize your ears. Even though you're not on the anchor line, you have to be very aware of what your ears are going to do. I'm going to be asking how much pressure you have in your tank. Brianna's telling me, she's telling me she has 2,000 PSI. How much do you have, Jeffrey? 10, 15, another 2,000 PSI. Very good on air. Okay. Kind of cruising along the wall here, looking at some of the soft corals that are on the little mini wall. We want to make sure to keep our depth anywhere between that 35 and 50 foot range while we're scuba diving along the wall. Notice that nobody's swimming up hard. Everyone is just naturally suspended in the water. That's that neutral buoyancy. We use the fins to propel ourselves forward, but we're not having to kick up and down all the time. Looking at some of the sponges there on the wall that grow plentiful around Cayman. Jeffrey's adjusting his BC here. It looks like he's putting a little air in so that he's not on the bottom. Nobody's fins are touching the bottom, which is very good. And some of the fish and schooling fish that we're going to be seeing when we're down there. In approaching fish, we do it very, very slowly so that we don't scatter them and they allow our presence down there. We're visitors in their home, so we like to just approach them very cautiously and slowly so that they stay in the area. Notice everybody is neutrally buoyant and not having to kick themselves off the bottom and breathing normally in and out, never holding your breath. When we're ready to come up, we'll want to empty our BCs so that we pull ourselves up the anchor line. We want to be on the anchor line with empty BCs and slowly, hand over hand, up the anchor line. We want to come up nice and slow. It has to be a foot a second or slower, but if we're on the anchor line and just hand over hand like Jeffrey is doing and Brianna, we're going to be coming up nice and slow, breathing all the time. Again, never holding our breath. We're under the water. Most important rule of scuba. And hand over hand up the anchor line. Once we reach the surface, after we've pulled ourselves up the anchor line, we're going to actually put in a little safety stop after every dive at about 15 feet for 3 minutes. After we spent that time there, then we're going to continue on to the surface. And that's the ball that was in front of the boat. When we're on the surface now, we're going to inflate our BCs so that we are buoyant and float on the surface as we swim to the back of the boat. Once we're in the back of the boat, we're buoyant, so we don't have to worry about sinking, but the first thing we're going to do is hand up our lead belt. That's the thing that you need the least at the end of your dive. So we're approaching the edge of the boat there. I'm going to exit the water first by getting on the ladder. And Jeffrey's taking off his lead belt, handing it to me with his right hand, so the buckle's facing downward, which is correct. I'll take it up, put it in the boat, and then we're going to take our tank off in the water. Remember, do the shoulder strap first, then the waist strap. Swing it off your right shoulder. I'll grab the tank and pull it in the boat for you. The last thing you want to do is take off your fins and put that in the boat. All right. Brianna's coming up. She's going to hand me her lead belt. Take that in the boat for her. She's going to be able to keep a regulator in her mouth. She did her shoulder strap. Now comes the waist strap. She keeps a regulator in her mouth until the last second. She doesn't have to break down the air system. No need for a snorkel here. And then when she's on the ladder, she hands the tank up, and all she has to do is take her fins off and climb on in. Another successful dive.